Great play call, great pass, great...
It is a perfect night here in the capital city of Atlanta, Georgia. We've got the roof open and we're ready to go at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. Tonight we close out week 7 with a good Monday night matchup between the Carolina Panthers and the Atlanta Falcons. Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, week 7 is underway on EA Sports. We'll see a return here from the end zone. This return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up the 27-yard line. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, this defense for the Panthers, they were terrific in the win over Tennessee a week ago.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away 4 times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw the ball? You try and run it more? Or do you tell your quarterback, make sure you see your guy open before you deliver?
2nd and 3. Open. That is Kyle Pitts, his tight end. He'll be taken down, not before working across midfield. A gain there of 21 yards.
That's his first catch of the game, and an impressive one against multiple defenders.
And how about that start? Really aggressive. Yeah, there was double coverage out there, but that didn't stop them at all. They went right at it and defeated it on that play.
Now on 1st down, he'll drop to throw it. Pressure comes in, he's brought down at the Panthers sack. Work to be done here on 2nd and 16 after the sack. Set up, throw. There is Amari Cooper, his first catch. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first? Here's a play fake as they set up, throw. Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Set back of the 29. Now back to throw. That's good. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. A really good pickup. 8 yards.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical, they've been crisp, and as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early 1st and goal.
Damn. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door. 1st and goal. Jair is not going to get back to the line of scrimmage as they'll tackle him at the 3. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down. Algier again, and he's not going too far. In fact, stopped dead in his tracks at the 3. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up something better here on 3rd and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening.
opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory?
And it is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Cordell Patterson with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Falcons put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead. Kua able to connect on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Following the touchdown, here's Kua to kick off. Taken from about the 12. And no alley to be found. The coverage was shut, and he's dropped at the 18.
Let's go now.
It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at 28.
Well, time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Second down, back to Sanders. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. The Panthers have the first. It's a gain of 12. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted last, they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give them the yards that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5. These two teams met in Atlanta earlier in the year with the Falcons winning that game. So a win here in Atlanta would give them the season sweep. The quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. What's like that in just about every position. And sometimes if you lose out leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away, and that's exactly what happened there.
They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass. Young to throw it. Sharp's got it, left side. And he's going to lose yardage here. This will wind up a loss on the play, and that's going to bring up a 4th down.
No surprise they decided to throw on 3rd down. A little bit of a surprise that they completed the pass and lost yardage on the play.
So on 4th down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. Cordero Patterson deep for Atlanta. And the bear catch is taken at about the 13-yard line here. Yeah, call it 38 yards on the punt. No return. And the Falcons will get it 1st and 10 deep in their own territory. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And Charles, what a battle this is within the division, because these guys, they've got the lead, but not by much. On the other side of the field, they're knocking on the door and trying to equal them in the risk category.
Second part that you talked about, equaling them in the wins category, because if somehow I get them to the end of the year and they're tied in record, head-to-head's always the first tiebreaker. The winner of this game, they'll have a big advantage.
here on first down. That's going to be caught by Pitts. He'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. First to 10, it's Patterson. And a pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. The Falcons at 5-1 here in this early part of the season. They're in a real groove of late. Winners of 5 of their last 6.
And I thought they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
Second and one. Oh, he'll run that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down.
Right up to that point, I was about to say he's had a pretty good half catch in the football, but let's just be honest about it. He should have caught that one.
And he knows that. That was one right in his breadbasket and one he normally catches. They'll run with Patterson. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. An effective 7-yard third down conversion.
That's about what you would expect since they're so efficient on picking up third downs in the top 5 in the NFL. It's all a mindset, and I guarantee you, starting in the offseason, third down's important. They find a way to pick them up at a very good clip.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. So the PI declined, and that'll give him a fresh set of downs.
And when you scout tight ends, one thing you want to know, just how strong they are. And we saw it in evidence there. He was able to fight through all the contact and still secure the football.
Back to throw now on first down. Touchdown lead now. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And that'll make the score 14-0. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to go off. Pulls it in at the 13. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this? You're still too early.
To the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive, but at the same time, you're wondering how we're going to move the football. What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics, usually your answer, and make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just hit it in his hand.
It's still second quarter, you get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
On second down, Young again. Oh, he tries to force it in, and the first picked up by J.C. Jackson. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, oh, I shouldn't have thrown that out.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about it. He shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
They'll come out throw here on first down. Oh, he's got man wide open, complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. They'll motion left. They'll look to throw now on first down. Throw out right, taken by Patterson. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do anyway. Two minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing.
Let's go.
Here's second and 10. About set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points, high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Throwing to start the drive, but that was incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Try again with the arm here on second down. Got this to the tight end Pitts. And he's able to get this to the 4-yard line before he's out of bounds. That goes for a gain of 31. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. He'll look to throw. He's going to fire the thing deep right sideline. And this is caught. Falcon touchdown. A great play there. 40 yards. And the Falcons are able to add on their first half lead. Well, you know, he can be explosive, and he's ultra explosive there. Fly around.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches and we've had to quote back to us, well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. But sometimes athleticism beats you well. He just took off and went. That was like one of your turkey bowl games, isn't it? Just go look,
backyard.
Man. I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
Koo now for the put after. And that PAT pushes the lead up to 23 now. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Pulls it in at the 13. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. It's Young on first down. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack. Going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Out of the gun, it's Young. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
A very limited time left to get into field goal range before the half, and they tried to get on one throw right there.
Young's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. That'll be caught by Rice. And they're going to get this up to midfield. Now another timeout called for by the offense. That means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Young out from the 50.
He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught. Got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can get some progress in this one.
Young to throw on fourth. And it's going to be batted down. And we'll go the other way with a football. Certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And this defense will take over right at midfield. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10, right at the 50-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. He's going to fire one deep over the middle and knock the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Well, he leads the NFL in interceptions and nearly added to that total.
Got his hand on it, couldn't quite corral it. It's been a Pro Bowl-type season for him, and the term ball hawk really comes into play, doesn't it?
Yeah, I like that one a lot because the team want to avoid that type of a player, but sometimes you just can't. Just know where the ball is.
And now a timeout defensively after the first down play, so they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. So after the inflation on first, now second and 10. Vice, 97, field, Cooper will come in motion right.
They'll throw down the final play. Over the middle complete. That's Patterson. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. So we have time here on a Monday night as we send you down to Orlando where John Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon getting set for quarter number three here. The Panthers get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play. In this second half, pulls it into 13. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down, shot to 20.
Let's go now.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And you have to think, Charles, on three scores already, they need to play an almost perfect second to have a solid chance.
Get the ball to the end zone and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game.
And I think the ball's out, and this is going to get out of bounds, so they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, in the heart of the football as well. So possession still theirs, but now they lose the third down. Now here's Young. A rifle's one, and that's going to be intercepted.
here trying to make something happen here in this third quarter, CD, but I don't think a pick six is exactly what they had in mind.
No, not at all, because this offense, they've been stuck all game long. Haven't done the scoreboard yet, and they're kind of forced to take a few chances here. That one, it backfired in a big way.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's air. And just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin the next drive. Well, we haven't exactly been treated a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, to be beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
You're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unfair.
Meanwhile, the throw by Young was knocked away and incomplete.
His offense has to be bumbling over, trying to find his team to the end for the first time. He did find a way to break contain and get outside. He has received his little extra time. The connection could be made on that throw. Certainly played to their top 10 defensive ranking this week. They've stifled this opposing defense throughout this game. This contest is now lopsided because of their efforts, and there's still a quarter to go.
Four down, Young. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked by J.C. Jackson. And the Falcons are going to take possession. So another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coach, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
Go over the middle, and it's complete time to drive. And they'll work this down inside the 30. Partner is still in the third quarter, but they've got this one well in hand and still airing it out with gusto and picking up some nice gains.
And even in lopsided games like this, you don't really see starters get lifted or the foot come off the gas before the fourth quarter. No one wants.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Von Bell. And the Panthers force the turnover. They take over at their own 27. For this defense in this ball game, but that's something right there. Still in the third quarter, it would take something around miracle territory for a comeback, but maybe that's the start, Charles.
It certainly is, and they're definitely showing that there's some fight still left in them. Hasn't been a banner day. They're trying their best with that.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by A.J. Brown. And the Falcons are going to get the football here at their 40-yard line. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears calculated correctly. Seven picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, the offense coordinator, the quarterback coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
Cooper, the man in motion right. Second nine now. Looking deep in the direction of Cooper. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think it'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
On play action, they'll throw.
And that is incomplete.
Nice call by the defense there on third down. Just flood the field with that defensive backs in their dime package. Nowhere to go with the football. Forces the incompletion.
Here's Bradley Pinion now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. Hey, yikes. Terrible kick headed straight for the sidelines. Out there and ready to begin their next drive.
It's a game that they would rather probably forget about, at least to this point, Charles. And one reason is turnovers. A turnover on the last drive, they had the issue.
He's got a man complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10. As they're down to the 29-yard line.
They'll run the screen with Hubbard.
And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards. Back to the third three. Throwing it on second down. Young. And now here's another interception. Picked up by J.C. Jackson. And the Falcons are going to have it here just past the 25.
Well, that is now his fifth interception thrown in this game. And, Charles, you've got to tip your cap to this defense. And they have been so impressive. Reading these passes, stepping in those lanes, and picking them off.
Yeah, sometimes the best offense is an excellent defense, and they've done exactly that. What do you think, Pat? A season worth of highlights in just four quarters? I think that's what we're seeing from this group.
A big hitter to start the drive as I'm up near midfield here for first and 10. And now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Second half blowout material.
Play action fake. They'll look to throw.
This pass is caught by London.
And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. They'll send receiver here in motion right.
Running the counter, Patterson.
And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line.
Second and 9 from the 10.
They'll set up to throw. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he'll be brought down. It's going to turn out. Time to come up with his third down play as we played three quarters. You're watching the NFL on eSports. The offense on third down tonight, they've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 4. Looking to throw. This to Pitts, and he's got it. Touchdown, Atlanta. A 5-yard touchdown catch, and the Falcons add on to the lead, and it's like that win streak is going to extend another week. Crew able to connect on the extra point, and this one was over a while ago as they add on to that big lead.
Following the touchdown, here's Crew kick off. Pulls it in at the 13. And he'll be brought down right on chalk of the 20.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin next drive.
And then
mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of four. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because tracking the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Throwing again on second down. Yup. This complete to Martin. And down he goes, but takes it up to the 40. Now here's a little touch pass as they tap quickly to their receiver.
Now they did get a little gain on this play, but all in all, a nice job defensively against the touch pass. They were able to string it out towards the sideline and never let him get corner and turn it upfield for a bigger chunk of yardage.
It's a second down run with Sanders, and it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. A loss on the play, and now third down gets tougher. Third and six. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Young on third down. And Martin's got it. Complete. But he won't quite make it. He needed six. He got about five. Fourth down. It's desperation time. Young on fourth down. And now look at this. Big game, but a fumble. And the Falcons have it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the field. With every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble.
Left thing 19.
Young off the play fake. And the Panthers are going to take over at their own 28-yard line.
Wait a second, they declined the penalty?
I'm as puzzled as you are, partner. I don't understand how any time you lose possession of the ball, yet you turn down a penalty that would give you possession back. But let's make this simple. Anyone who plays the game, take the football. Always take the football.
Ready, go!
They look to throw here on first down. Throwing right and it's complete. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. 33 yards that time. They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And give him another six. It's caught for a touchdown. And the blowout continues.
Cool for the extra point.
And this one was over a while ago as it's add on to their big lead. The touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And here comes a return beyond the goal line. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. I hate to say it, but at this point, I don't really know that they're playing to win with this deficit in the fourth quarter. They're just trying to erase that zero on the scoreboard, Charles, and get some type of momentum to carry to the film session tomorrow.
Any type of points on the board, it'll count as a moral victory, although no one will talk about that in the post-game press conference. That's not something you mentioned in the NFL. This loss, it already stings him for a while, but everyone on that offense knows it'll sting a lot worse if they don't put some points up on the board.
Looking to throw again on second down. Young. His throw incomplete.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to put that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
Now Young. And my goodness, another interception. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he'll be out of bounds here just past the 20-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
A second down throw for Young. He's going to drop this down to Sears. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. Young working out of the gun. And once again, this is Sanders. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. That'll go for a gain of 7, and that'll bring up 2nd down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he was unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective game nonetheless.
Buffalo 18.
Play action. Young. To Martin. And up this down to around the 47-yard line.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential, but when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
5 men in the secondary now for the Falcons on 3rd down. Young. That is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
And that's another painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Here we go. Here we go.
Now Young on 4th down. And it's going to be battled down. We'll go the other way with the football. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. But the Falcons defense stands tall, they'll get the football back. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. They've got to be feeling very comfortable and confident here with this lead in the football here in the 4th quarter, Charles. And I don't think that they need to score again, but it seems like this offense is just getting better as the game goes on. They've scored on their last 2 drives.
Certainly feels like a chance for them to continue to have some fun there, doesn't it? Game's already decided to devote it. So they can continue to play loose, break out some other concepts. Maybe run a few trick plays, get people involved. Heck, even go deep on one of these first snaps just because they can.
That one looks like he'll throw here. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. And one of the whistles, timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. Ritter and the Falcons need an answer and a big play here on third and long following the sack. They'll look to throw here. They'll rifle this one deep right side. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Well, I think it's pretty evident that any blowout isn't going to be big enough for them. They're already up 7 full touchdowns. And it's still not stopping them from throwing it deep downfield, taking their shots, trying to add more points.
Here's Bradley Pinion now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. So time runs out. It's a victory for the Atlanta Falcons. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense is they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they're looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory. So for the Falcons, they remain one of the hottest teams out there as the win moves to 6-1. And they'll get to stay put for a few days as they'll host the Houston Texans next week. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, the loss drops them back to 4-3 so far. And they'll try to turn things around next week